So please, so on request, we provide offline versions also that can be installed in your machines and then can be demonstrated to the teacher students as when required. So this is the content of a lab, that complete e-lab under one roof. Suppose there is an experiment of bell jars as shown in the presentation. So that not only we have concentrated on the simulator, means the practical component. First, we have given the theory, that what is the conceptual background of the experiment, what are the concept related laws, what are the proofs or the principles which a student requires to know before performing the experiment. Then the procedure is the detailed step. We have provided two steps here. One is that how the student have to perform in the physical lab in the school, and the other is here on the online environment, here on olabs.edu.in, how he has to perform the experiment. The animation is for teachers, that the teacher can demonstrate the class or the student before taking to the lab, and student will get to know how they have to perform the activity. The simulation is a laboratory environment with the necessary apparatus, where a student will be need to conduct the experiments online. Also, with each lab, we have put 5 to 20 objective MCQ questions also. So randomly student can answer those questions, and a teacher will come to know whether the student have understood the practical completely or not. These are some of the using scenarios that we have found out that can be changed as per you, that we have written, and that you can, creative teachers and students can come up with many more innovative uses of this online lab. So as a teacher can use this to explain the lab before performing the practical lab session in the classroom. Also, this can be used as a backdrop so that the teacher can frame questions and ask questions to the students in the class after the lab session is done. A student can pre-lab familiarize with the lab, and also after lab revision, the student can try out various variants, reinforce the concept, answer questions of the Viva Voice, or that all can be done. Now, this is the offline version, that to facilitate schools constrained with internet users, we have offline versions also of this OLAPS, that we have two models. One is a DVD, that is an offline bootable DVD that consists of all the labs, and the other is an OLAPS installer. We will be giving you a link also in the chat box after the completion of this workshop, from where you can download this installer. Also, just can be dispatched to your place also when the things get normal after the COVID-19 pandemic. We can distribute the DVD also on request to the required schools. It's a screenshot for that installer. So also the Android app is also available, that you can download it from Google's Play Store. That it, the only requirement is the internet required to access each lab. Also, all the activities are touch enabled, that any handheld device or a tablet, a mobile phone or any screen can be used to perform the experiments. This was a letter issued to us in February 2013 by CBSE. That time chairman Sri Vineet Joshi sir recommended to come up with the online lab experiments, where we have developed this activity. Then again in 2016, we get a circular from CBSE so that it can be rolled out to every individual school of the country. So from that purpose only, we are doing this training, that online workshop to the teachers of the school. Based on CBSE, Navodaya Vidyalaya Samiti and Kendriya Vidyalaya Sangathan also issued respective letters to their schools to get the training done for the online labs. This was the Navodaya Samiti letter. For this project online labs, we have got awards also, that CSIRT Excellence Award for 2013, Scotch Order of Merit, and also shortlisted for Jury Award for NASCOM 2013. The project was itself launched by Honorable Minister of IT, Sri Ravi Shankar Prasad, in 2015 during the Digital India Week of celebrations in New Delhi. So this is the state-wise figure, that in which state, how many teachers we have covered and how many schools we have trained. This data is available on the website also. This can be shown under the training tab. And also the online figures are here, that this is the key metrics, that we have trained almost 33,054 teachers till now, and on online portals we have more than 210,000 users registered with us for the OLAPS. So this is a screenshot, that this is our homepage about in the news, workshop, training, registration, contact, and the flag is for language change. We have categorized it as a physics, chemistry, biology, mathematics, and English. So my colleague will now give you a demonstration of all the subjects, one lab from each subject, how you have to use this online labs. Currently, our website is under maintenance due to some labs we are updating. So we have put that on update. Visible.
Yes, sir.
Okay, so this is our offline version, which we have for physics, chemistry, biology, maths, and English. I will demonstrate you physics. Now you can see the physics we have done is as class 9th, class 10th, class 11th, and class 12th. Like this, the activities are we have arranged. So you can open one activity of your choice, and we can start. I will give you a demonstration how it works. So this is a theory, Ohm's law. What is the aim? Then the procedure is the material required and the procedure of the physical lab. Then what are the observations which are to be required? The tables which we need, value which we put, all is there. Then the simulation. You can see this is the part where we have to perform the activity. Now if the student want a help, he can use this show circuit diagram. From here, I will get the help. Now from here, I can choose the metal, on which metal I want to do the experiment. I can change the length of the wire from here. I can change the diameter of the wire from here. Just click and I can change the resistance value from here. Now, as per the instructions, it says that we have to connect this terminal to this. We have to put this, connect this wire to this. Then as I will move rheostat, the value of rheostat will also move. I will put the switch in here and then I will put the do the connections from here to the battery and to the ammeter and the voltmeter. So like this, all these connections can be done. And if you need the student need the help, so he can see that the on clicking on the help, he will get the help also. That change the length of the resistant wire, change the diameter of the resistant. So step by step, what student have to do is given in the procedure and how the student have to perform. This is a simulator where they have to actually do the activity. Then the Viva voice is again where I was telling you the options. So these are the questions which we have put. We have to just student have to just select the answer of his choice in the online version, and just on in the bottom you can see on the clicking on the submit button in the end on the online portal with the tick of right or wrong, it will tell me whether my answers are right or wrong. Also, resources are available if student want to go deep into the activity or want to read some more content. We have some links and the pages with books which we have followed. So here student can do more experiments also. I will give you show you some activities or videos also, animations also after some time. So this is for chemistry, again the same concept, class 9, 10th, 11th and 12th. This is the activity, you can see a chemical reaction. Kindly keep your mic mute please. So the objective, the theory, the different chemical reactions which we are going to read is all here. Then the procedure is here. What are the material required? What is the lab procedure? What is the simulator procedure? What are the inferences? What are the precautions? So everything which is required in a lab, we have tried to put it here on the portal. And the animation is here. And the simulation is a code. The part which is not there here right now because of the Adobe Flash Player is disabled right now for the Chrome. I will give you a demonstration of this also once. Then the biology. Plant and animal tissues. Objective. The theory. Again the procedure. Animation and the simulator part, as you can see here, that which view I want. It's a microscopic view or a binocular view. I can change the view from here. Or what is the sample I want? I have 4 or 5 samples available here. I can change the sample from here. From this options, I can change the objective, the lens power. This is a high power. Now here, these are the adjustments available that I will right, left. If I want to do some fine adjustment, I can do some fine adjustment also. If I want to identify part, I will click on this. It will show me the parts also. So like that, the student can perform the activity and change the mode. If I want to again change, go from the binocular view to the telescope microscopic view, I will click and will go like this. So like that, a student have to perform the experiment. It's all with the help of mouse only that he has to perform these experiments here on the online portal. Then for mathematics, right now we have only for class 9, 10, 10th till now. We are in the process to coming up for class 11th and 12th also. Again, the theory, procedure, simulator, self-evolution is the Viva Voice questions, the numerical question based on the formula. Suppose for the right of volume of flats of the cylinder, how they have to perform. This can be done. In mathematics, we have
Excuse me,
you can please mute. So
you can see. तो तू दूध लेकर तो कुछ मैंने कर लिया करे. किस कर लिया करे फिर?
ये रखिए अगले दिन तक मैं छेड़ता नहीं.
So you can see that this is the volume of flat circular cylinder, the definition, the type of cylinder, the prerequisite knowledge if required. I will click on start. So these all are dynamic activities that you can see that I will click at any place in this workbench. So this is a dynamic quadrilateral ABCD which has been drawn. I have a scale on the left, so student can use this scale. Now the next step is that on the top left you can see the in the black box there is the instructions, and in the bottom you can see there is an observation. So what we have to do is return the instructions and how it will come out. It will be given in the observation. Now it says that I have to select the midpoint of each side, and then we have to join this midpoint to form a new quadrilateral inside the quadrilateral ABCD. So I will join this all. Now this is a new quadrilateral PQRS which has been created inside the quadrilateral ABCD. I will take it out. Now I will join the sides point P with R to cut this quadrilateral into two triangles, and we will try to impose one triangle to the other. So the sides will become equal, and by the theorem we will try to prove that the quadrilateral is a parallelogram by definition. This is the as per the lab written in the lab manual which we have followed. So you have joined these two rectangles. We have colored them differently. I will click on the cut triangle. Now it has been cutted, and I will rotate. I will rotate it so that it will cover the other triangle. I cannot just drag that any other place. It will not go. I have to try again. A student has to try again and keep closer to the other triangle. So now you can see the conclusion says that the triangle PQR covers triangle PSR exactly. Thus, SP is equal to QR and RS is equal to PQ. Therefore, quadrilateral PQRS is a parallelogram by definition. So like that, we have come to a conclusion. Now a student can restart this activity again. He can change the side, the length of the initial quadrilateral ABCD and perform this activity again and again as per his choice. Now, English is a noble concept which came in our mind that we have not categorized it on a class basis. That you can see that we have four activities for prepositions, two activities for active passive, one activity for tense conversion, one for comprehension, one for direct and indirect speech. Then subject verb agreement and singular and plural. Like that we have categorized these activities. I will give you a demonstration of this tense conversion. So first is the theory, the all the rules and the procedures with how we need to convert the tense. Then once the student will click on this start, we'll get this UI. Now you can see from which tense there is a list available here and to which tense I have to convert. As I will change this, all the activity is dynamic. The sentence will change, the output sentence will change, and the word repository will also get changed. So now you can see there is a sentence that Charles catches a ball, and I have to convert, a student have to convert this into present continuous tense. Now what a student have to do, he has to drag the word from word repository and submit in the blank spaces. Now I am doing it randomly. I will click on submit. So you can see that the feedback here, we are only not giving that your answer is right or wrong. It is a elaborated feedback that you can see the mean verb is correct, but the helping verb is not correct. So helping verb should be selected properly. Accordingly, student can change again and submit. Now you can see my mean verb and helping verb both are correct. So once I will click on next, the sentence will get changed. So all these are dynamic sentences which will not get repeated, and student can do a practice as many times as he wants. So this is for the activities, how the simulations has to be done. Now I will take you to the videos, some videos which I have kept, because the website is not up right now. I will show you from the local host, from other sources, the animations which we have for this online labs. So as you can see, this is the video. I will just play this.
Materials required. We will require permanent slides of parenchyma tissue and sclerenchyma tissue and a compound microscope. Procedure. Take the permanent slide of the parenchyma tissue and place it on the stage of the compound microscope. Adjust the mirror of the microscope carefully until the image you see has maximum clarity. Observe the permanent slide of the parenchyma tissue under the low power lens and then under the high power lens of the compound microscope. Move the slide very slowly back and forth to identify the different parts of the parenchyma tissue. Repeat.
So like this, it was for biology. I will give you a demonstration of chemistry also.
Colored anhydrous copper sulfate, CuSO4. Remove the boiling tube from the flame and cool it for some time. Using a dropper, take a small quantity of distilled water. Add 2 to 3 drops of water into the boiling tube containing the sample anhydrous copper sulfate obtained after heating. The white copper sulfate turns blue, indicating that the blue-colored hydrated copper sulfate is regenerated. So this reaction is a reversible chemical change. Reaction of iron nail with an aqueous solution of copper sulfate. We will require copper sulfate, iron nail.
So what we do actually in the chemistry lab, we have tried to keep same environment, same apparatus, so the student will not get confused. It will get some interesting, build some interest in the student while performing these activities. Now I will show you for the physics also, which I was showing you. So Ohm's law.
To the positive terminal of ammeter using a connecting wire. connect the negative terminal of the ammeter to the positive terminal of the voltmeter using a connecting wire. The negative terminal of the voltmeter is connected to the upper terminal of the rheostat using a piece of wire. Connect the lower terminal of the rheostat to one end of the one-way key, that is, the key should be removed, using a connecting wire. The other free end of the one-way key is connected to the negative terminal of the battery. Now, take a resistance wire, stretch it and measure its length using a meter scale and cut the wire at the given point. Connect it in parallel to the terminals of the voltmeter, that is, positive to negative. The connection is completed. Now, insert the key and slide the rheostat contact to check the working of the ammeter and voltmeter. Adjust the sliding contact of the rheostat and note down the value of potential difference V from voltmeter and current I from the ammeter. Record the reading of the voltmeter and ammeter. Shift the rheostat contact slowly and record the reading of the voltmeter and ammeter and calculate the value of R in each case. Shift the rheostat contact slowly. Similarly, take at least 5 sets of independent observations.
So like that, all other activities that you can see are available.